Hi, I'm Shane, and welcome to Lohre Farm. This is my wife, Sarah, and we thought we would take a little bit of time to introduce ourselves for anybody coming onto the channel and kind of wondering, who are these people, what do they do, what types of farming activities do they deal with? So over the next 7 days, we're going to release one video each day highlighting a little aspect of what we do here and what we've learned over the past 5 years of living here. We bought our property in August of 2017, so we're coming up on almost exactly 5 years of being here. We've learned a heck of a lot. There's been tons of stuff that we probably won't do ever again. There are some things that we have definitely learned that we probably will continue to do. So we bought the property in August 2017. The previous owners had horses, so they had a small little horse stable out back. And I guess our initial thought to the property wasn't so much farming. I'm not even sure it was much for growing, much for food.
Well, I wanted a garden.
Well, yeah, Sarah wanted a garden. Where we lived before was kind of more of a typical neighborhood. Our property is 10 acres. About 4 acres of it is kind of where the house sits. Originally it was grass mowed, manicured lawn type grass, and became like a pasture. So when we moved in, one of the first things that I did was had to mow everything. And coming from a suburban house, all I had was a small little push mower. And I remember one of the earlier conversations was that I wanted to get a riding lawnmower, and Sarah kind of, if I remember right, hemmed and hawed a little bit about that.
At that point too, though, there was a lot less lawn exposed, because after we moved in, we cleared out a lot more area than was actually being utilized. Actually, all the way up until the pond, because most people didn't even know there was a pond on this property. We needed to get a rider because it was ridiculous amount of property to push mow.
First time on the rider was 5 hours. I think that was more my appeal, to have a larger size garden in the end than what we ended up thinking we were gonna start with. So anyways, you didn't even realize the pond existed. Unless you were, you know, wanted to go back there and wade through all the weeds to get there. And when you finally did get there, the for most people, the pond probably wasn't that impressive. It was just an old duck pond, kind of a low spot in the property that had filled in. And
another really cool thing about the property too, there is a creek.
I mean, it's a county drainage ditch, but it basically looks like a little creek. It's been there as long as we can look back on the property. It was there, my guess was, it was probably dug sometime in the, I know it was there in 1960, so it's probably predates, you know, that, probably in the 40s it was dug or something like that to help drain some of the local farm fields. But yeah, that's actually really a pretty thing. You get back in there and start looking at that, and most people probably wouldn't even know it's a drainage ditch, honestly. I know I've included it in a few videos, and it looks like a small little, almost like a babbling brook or whatever you want to call it. It's just a tiny little creek, beautiful. And that kind of separates our property from the neighbors east of us.
And also the woods. The woods is a nice attraction. Yeah. It gives you a little more privacy.
Half of the property is kind of like a wooded tree area. I almost refer to it as like a series of groves that kind of grew together over the years. I know that north of the pond, that pretty much is just sitting natural. North of the pond is about as natural as it could be. Nothing has been touched out there for many, many decades. I know that based on satellite photos. But I do know that north of the pond was farmed in the 60s. We ended up buying quite a few apple trees and plum trees and pear trees and adding those to the front of our property in hopes that down the road that'll provide quite a bit of fruit for us to be able to go out there and pick and enjoy. The trees are quite young, so you know they're still kind of getting their roots into the ground and to start producing in the future.
I think one of the funnier things when we moved here though, I wanted raspberry bushes. So we splurged and bought a couple, which I thought were kind of expensive at the time.
I think we bought one and it was like $38 or something.
They were expensive. Yeah. So we bought couple raspberry bushes, and then come to find out the woods is pretty much all raspberry bushes, wild raspberry bushes that are delicious, and it was a great surprise, but it was just kind of funny.
Right, yeah, there's probably 10,000 raspberry bushes on the property already, and didn't know it until later on. So yeah, the windmill was a really cool addition. Bought it online, came in boxes, assembled it in the garage. Sarah's dad came up and my dad came up to help get it set up. But it's pretty cool. It can pump water if you wanted it to pump water. You know, I suppose if you hooked it up right, it could also could produce electricity, but the main thing that it does is it has a diaphragm inside of it that every time it turns, it flexes a diaphragm that you can run air lines and it can become aerators for ponds or different things like that. So that was kind of the idea with it, was to use it as aeration for the pond. Last summer, one of the strangest things that has happened since we lived here is we went through a really big drought last summer. And I think it was probably about midsummer, the pond level had dropped down so that it was like nothing left. And so I ended up, got a hold of a local guy who does excavating and different things like that, and kind of had him come out and take a look at things. And we started talking about maybe restoring it, you know, over the years that basically tons and tons of silt had just settled in the bottom of the pond. So it wasn't very deep. It was a puddle. Basically have spent the last few months doing a pond restoration, going through, digging out on just one part of it, and rebuilding the bank and making it so that wildlife and animals and different things can have a lot more attraction to that spot. I know that when we first moved here, there really wasn't much for ducks or anything out there. I think the first year we ended up putting in like 9 wind duck houses or something, and a few mallard houses out into the pond. And immediately we started noticing that following year, I think one or two of the nesting boxes
started hatching.
So, yeah, the ducks came, they found them. A little bit more work needs to be done on it. One thing this spring, it's basically been a flood. It's been just absolutely crazy. I don't remember ever having this much rain day after day after day, to the point where
really makes it hard to finish up the project.
Yeah, it really makes
it frustrating, especially when you go from drought year to tsunami.
Right, yeah. Yeah, one year where there's no rain, and then the next year where it won't stop raining. And so hopefully that'll be wrapped up really soon. It's going to be absolutely gorgeous when it's done. And probably most importantly for me, and I think Sarah too, we've talked about it, it'll be really, really nice for habitat. Stop fidgeting.
I can't sit still because I'm not capable of it.
It's fine because this is going to be all edited, and a lot of what we're saying is going to be not us on camera. It's going to be photos and video and of everything we're talking about. So yeah, and the windmill was a cool addition.
I don't think you're filming, are you?
Yeah.
Oh, well,
I'm the one watching the goddamn thing.